Hey everyone, welcome to another Living Waters Community Group session. And this week, one of the questions we've been looking at is, what's one of the boldest things you've ever done? One of the boldest things I've ever done was when I was 17 and I went to one of the local preachers in my Methodist circuit, which is like a group of Methodist churches. And I said, I want to preach the gospel. And then I started this journey of being examined by various preachers. I had to preach, I had to study, and after 4 years through this process, I became fully accepted to the office of lay preacher in the Methodist Church of Great Britain. It was a bold move, but I wanted to preach the gospel and share it with others. Another bold thing I've done in my life was I asked an American to marry me. Now, marriage is bold enough in the first place, but for me, marriage meant I had to leave my family, my country, my friends, all that behind in England. I had to move to America, and it's been worth it. And it was scary at every step of the way, but I got here, and I married the most beautiful woman in the world. Plus, I got to get married in Yosemite National Park, which makes for fantastic wedding photos. They look something like this. So we all have moments in our lives where we make big, bold actions or big, bold statements. Points in our lives where we step outside of our comfort zones and take a risk. These decision moments, these actions often have big consequences. And one of Jesus' disciples went through one of these big moments of boldness when he was on the road with Jesus near a place called Caesarea Philippi. Jesus was walking with his disciples, the 12 of them, plus a few extras in that, and he asked them, who do the people who we meet say the Son of Man is? Who do they say I am? And the disciples list off this list of people. You know, some think you're the prophet Jeremiah, some think you're John the Baptist, some think you're a prophet. You know, they have this list of people that they run off, all big characters from Israel's history. And then Jesus asks them, who do you think I am? And Peter stands forward and he goes, you are the Christ, the Messiah, the Son of God. And Jesus replies to Peter, blessed are you, Peter. You are the rock on which I will build my church, and the gates of hell will not overcome it. I will give you the keys to heaven, and what you bind on earth, you will bind in heaven, and what you loose on earth, you will loose in heaven. So that's a pretty good day for Peter. And as they continue to walk along the road and over the next few days, Jesus begins to teach them about how he has to die, how he has to suffer. And the disciples find this really hard to deal with. And Peter, this guy who had made this great bold statement just a day or so before, goes, that'll never happen. You can't die. I mean, look, you're the Messiah. You're God's chosen. You're the Son of God. It just cannot happen. And Jesus looks at Peter and he says, get behind me, Satan. You are a stumbling block to me because you do not have in your head the things of God, but instead the things of humans. And then Jesus tells his disciples something really rough. He says, if anyone would come after me, they have to first pick up their cross and follow me. For whoever wants to save their life will lose it. And whoever loses life will find it. And that's the kind of hard message that Jesus gives to those who are bold. Those who are bold enough to say, I believe Jesus is the Son of God. I believe Jesus is the Lord and Savior. So as you go through your discussion today, reflect on where you are faith-wise. Have you got as far as Peter in declaring Christ? Have you not? Are you scared of what might happen? Are you willing to take on what happened? Are you already further down the path and have been serving him in that roughness for quite a time? I hope that you'll have a discussion that will deepen and enrich your faith as you go through today. God bless. Have a great discussion. Bye.